Good day, dear students. Welcome back. After this class about forces, we need to go through how to add these forces, especially when it comes to the idea of vectors. How to add these two vectors if I have two forces acting through the same point or the same body. But before we start, I want to announce something was jumping to my mind when I was in your age. Like, how could I subtract a big number out of smaller number and the results should be another third number? Like, if I say in math 5 minus 6, the answer is negative 1. When I was in your age, it doesn't make sense with me because I cannot take anything out of nothing. When I study physics well, I understood that we cannot take a smaller number out of much smaller number. We cannot take a big number out of smaller number because in physics, simply, we have no any number below zero. When I say negative in physics, it means in the opposite direction. And keep in mind, the positive and negative in physics, the angle between them is 180 degrees. So when I say the body is moving with a speed is like 3 meters per second to the right, and another body is moving with another speed like 3 meters per second to the left, it doesn't mean that one of them faster than the other. They are just different in direction. And this is the difference between positive and negative in physics. So when I say positive or negative in physics, it means we have two directions. The difference between them is just 180 degrees. Let's see that if we are gonna divide the class into three parts, we will add forces if they were acting in the same line, in the same direction, or into opposite direction. And the third part, if we have an angle between these two vectors, if it was forces or any other vector, how could we deal with that? By looking to that figure, we could observe if I have two forces acting in one body, but they are acting in the same direction, like 30 Newton and 20 Newton, both are acting to the right. So when I add them, both of them could be considered positive or negative, it depends on you. So I could say 30 plus 20, because they are acting in the same direction, so both of them have the same sign. And this positive in between, just for adding. So I'm gonna say 30 plus 20, the answer will be 50 Newton to the same direction that they're both acting through. But if they were different in directions, like 30 Newton acting to the right and 20 Newton acting through the same point or on the same body to the left, in that case, we need to assign one direction with one sign. Like 30 Newton, if it was to the right, I'm going to assign it positive. 20 Newton, if it was to the left, I'm going to assign it as a negative. So when I say 30 plus 20, I need right now to add the two forces, but with respect to that direction. So I'm gonna say 30 plus negative 20. Negative 20 here, it doesn't mean a number below zero. It means 20, and it makes 180 degrees to the previous one. So I'm gonna say 30 plus negative 20, so the answer will be just 10 Newton. Observe 10 Newton here. It has a sign which is positive. It means it's in the same direction like what we consider positive from the main forces. In the other case, if you change your mind and you change the direction of the sign itself, if you consider the direction right is negative and the direction left is positive, so you could say negative 30 plus 20, so the answer will be negative 10. Keep in mind, the direction stays to the right, because actually negative in that case means right. So we didn't change the direction. In the third case, we could study some different, like if we have an angle between the two forces, whatever the angle is. Actually, we have many ways to deal with that, but the best way, according to IGCSE, and the most accurate way, and it could save your time during the exams, is to use a compass. As you see in that figure, I'm going to draw F1 in a specific direction, and F2 in another specific direction, between these two vectors, we have an angle. We could consider that angle as theta. Whatever the value of angle is, what you need to do to find the resultant force, just assign a scale. Like, to find this scale, you could change the length of the force from centimeters, for example, into newtons, like these two examples. If I say 2.5 centimeter acting to the right, and I wrote 10 centimeters, so the scale here means 1 centimeter is equivalent to 4 newton. If I say 20 newton to the right, and the length of the line is 5 centimeter, so I could say the scale here is 1 centimeter equivalent to 4 newton. We could use any of these scales, or whatever the scale that you could assign for your example. In this example, I will draw F1 acting to the right and F2 acting, it looks like a little between top to the right. There is an angle between the two forces, as you see. The best way to draw the resultant force is, first of all, assign a scale, like measure the length of the arrow and assign a scale, like how many centimeters represent how many newtons. Then we could use the canvas, open the canvas as F1, but use it from the end of F2 and draw an arc. Then open it as much as F2 and use it from the end of F1 and draw another arc. These two arcs will intersect in a point. This point represents the end of the resultant force, as you see in that figure. Then after that, you can measure the length of the resultant force and using the scale to find the value of that force. If you like the idea, please do subscribe to the channel. See you next class.